All right, we agree that we admire Nastia Liukin because of her Olympic accomplishments.
Yeah.
But more importantly, Liberty and I agree, we love your hair.
It's beachy wave that is best.
Yeah, it's like a living.
My hairstylist lead this
morning. All right. So how does a Boston girl become all California?
I love California.
I'm
from Texas.
Okay.
But my fiance lives in Boston,
right.
So we're there now. But we're actually going to be moving out here next month.
Oh, just to pursue all things or what?
Yeah, kind of a little bit of everything. We started a business together about inspiring the next generation of young athletes. Mm-hmm. And so we've been working a lot out here. So I'm going to continue doing that.
The one thing that is startling to me, my daughter has some friends who are interested and very involved in gymnastics. That quote unquote lifespan is from what to what?
It's crazy because I retired when I was 22, and competing at 22 was like grandma status.
Yeah.
It was over the hill. That's so you crazy. Really peak between 16 and 18, and so when I competed at the Olympics, I was almost 19, and that was kind of old for gymnastics.
Wow. So. And do you feel that your body, I don't know, behaves or responds differently at 19 than at 16?
Oh, absolutely, because I tried to make a second Olympic team after, and competing at 21 and 22, I could really feel the difference.
Yeah.
It was like everything hurt, everything was so much harder.
I think it was the last Olympics where there was a 40-year-old.
Oh, yeah, so she actually
She's my hero.
With my dad.
What?
Competed with me and is still competing.
Oksana, yeah.
Yeah, she's incredible, but it's not for me.
all right, this is an event called Heart. It's close. Look at me. I'm so dumb. It's an event that's close to your heart. Tell us about Jump, Jive, and Thrive.
Yeah, I'm really excited. I haven't performed in a while, so I'm going to be performing again. And, you know, we are raising money for cancer survivors. And my grandmother passed away from cancer. And then Valerie, who is the head coach at UCLA Gymnastics, she had cancer as well and survived. And so we're kind of honoring her. A lot of the UCLA Gymnastics team is going to be performing. Madison Koshin, who was, of course, on that Olympic team this past year in Rio. And then some of my Olympic teammates, Sam Peschek and Alicia Sacramone, are going to be there. Lori Hernandez, who we saw, she won Dancing with the Stars. She'll be doing some dancing stuff as well, so it'll be fun.
Poly Pavilion is the most fabulous local venue for gymnastics. I've seen so many great performances there. The difference between a competition and something like this, which is more fun,
yes.
What's the preparation then?
Well, it's definitely not training 7 hours a day, 6 days a week. Of course, we'll all get back into the gym and start training a little bit, choreographing our routines and getting ready for the show, but to be honest, there's not a lot of pressure. There's obviously no judges. And it's really fun for us to be able to perform in front of the fans, because when you're competing, you're performing, but you're also not really focused on everyone else around you. And when you're performing in a show like this, you really get to engage with the crowd and the audience and the kids there. And it's going to be a lot of fun.
Musical performance as well. Our friend Melissa Etheridge will be there. Natasha Bedingfield. Lots of great people in that regard. But here's the thing. At your heart, you're an athlete.
Yeah.
But you're an entertainer too.
And I think that's what I miss most about competing, is I miss that entertainment part. I miss being so nervous that I felt like I was going to be
you
sick.
You miss that?
I do. There's like this weird feeling that when it's all over, you're like, okay, I want to do it again. But during the time you're, and also I think it's like that training aspect of, you spent your entire life for that one moment, that it's very nerve wracking. Mm-hmm. It's pretty scary, but at the same time, it's so thrilling. And I don't think there's too many things in life that can compared to that feeling.
Yeah.
That is very well said. I think professional skaters from the Olympics, there is this afterlife of professional skating. Is there a gymnastics afterlife?
Well, I mean, we're lucky enough to do a tour every 4 years after the Olympics, which we just did after these Rio Olympics, which was so much fun. And this show is just like that. So to be able to perform, and who knows, maybe if it's successful, we could take it on the road and it could become a tour. But as you said, we're all performers at heart. So I think we're all just really excited to get back out there on the floor and perform.
All right. Our friend Liberty is very good at yoga.
Ooh, yes.
Which is hard.
I'm okay.
I'm a huge fan of yoga, too. So maybe we could go together.
Absolutely.
I'm going to be new to the area.
Let's go.
Nastia some yoga studios.
You know what? That would be a very
Happy
nice to welcome
to
LA kind of thing. Here we go. Jump, Jive, and Thrive. The live event for the whole family. Poly Pavilion. It's Sunday, October the 8th. Tickets available at Ticketmaster.com, Poly Pavilion's box office on the UCLA campus. They're taping the thing to air on CBS on October 21st. And again, Poly Pavilion is just a great venue to see things. Really nice to meet you. Thanks for coming
in this morning. Thanks for having me.
Thank you. And we look forward to seeing you in LA when you move here.